Hello and welcome to ET Auto Big Bite, a show that brings to you industry top leader. Today I'm joined by Mr. CV Raman, Senior Executive Director Engineering at country's leading passenger vehicle manufacturers, Maruti Suzuki India. Welcome to ET Auto Big Bite.
Hello, Nabeel. Sir.
There are two things that we are talking about today. One is technology, the other one is the market situation. So let's begin with technology, as that's your forte. How ready are we for the BS6, and what kind of cost implication, if you could explain in a very deep dive manner for our viewers?
So as Maruti Suzuki is concerned, we have already launched 7 models in BS6 avatar. These are all petrol engines, and we hope that the balance work, we will try to complete it before the deadline and ensure that our customers get the BS6 variant as early as possible. We have actually more than 50 variants, and when I say 50 variants, it's about petrol, CNG, manual transmission, automated manual transmission, or CVT, AT, any combination of this becomes a variant. So we have more than 50 variants. We've done about 30% of that work, which is constituting 50% of the volume. So now we will start the balance work in the next couple of months. You will see in the next 3 months, all the other vehicle also will become BS6.
I've been getting, a lot of queries on why the cost will go up with BS6. So can you explain in a simple term for the viewer why the cost is expected to go, and in which variant you expect higher?
So in BS6, there are two, I'll split it into two. And of course, we are in gasoline only, but I'll explain about diesel also. So as far as gasoline is concerned, there is we need to improve the NOx level and the hydrocarbon level. So therefore, we need to improve the after treatment system. Also, we need to improve the fuel efficiency. Therefore, there'll be a change in the powertrain. So every manufacturer will have their own strategy of vehicle and powertrain to do that work. That is the one thing which you need to do. The other thing which we need to, as far as BS6 is concerned, is also that there is a new norm which is there, which is coming in BS6, which is not there in BS4, which is the in-service conformity. In-service conformity is like emissions conformity of production. Emission conformity of production is done by picking up 3 new vehicles from the manufacturer. But in-service conformity is you pick up 3 vehicles from the customer, which have done 15,000 kilometers or up to 5 lakh, up to 1 lakh kilometer, and between 6 months to 5 years of age. And they have to be regularly serviced. 3 vehicles will be picked up. There's a family concept which is there. So there's some way of picking up those vehicles. They have to be sent to the test agency. The test agency will check and see whether the emissions are meeting the norm as per the earlier, whatever was homologated, whether it is meeting as per that or not. So that means added work as far as engineering is concerned. So therefore, the durability, reliability of the catalyst and the after treatment system becomes even more stringent. In order to meet that, the cost goes up. So roughly in a gasoline, it could go anywhere from 8,000 to 15,000 rupees, depending on the powertrain which you have got. Now let's talk about diesel. Diesel is a little bit more complex. In diesel, we are trying to reduce the particulate matter, and we are also trying to improve the NOx levels. So in Europe, the Euro 4 went to Euro 5 and then to Euro 6. In Euro 5, they improved the particulate matter. In Euro 6, they improved the NOx. By doing a transition from Euro 4 to Euro 6 directly, that means from BS4 to BS6, we have skipped one step, and we need to do both of them together. So we have to decrease the particulate matter, also improve the NOx. 2 new technologies need to be added. One is the DPF, the diesel particulate filter, to reduce the particulate matter. Second is LNT or SCR technology in some cases, you will see, which is a selective catalyst reduction where urea is injected. So this is the new thing which has to be added. And also engine improvements may be required to be done in order to meet the fuel efficiency requirements. And so all of this cost goes up. So typically our understanding is that from a BS4 petrol to diesel, price point difference is 1 lakh rupees. It may go up in a small car to maybe 1.75 lakhs or 2 lakh rupees in the case of BS6. And all the other things which I talked about of in-service conformity is also applicable for that. The added challenge, of course, for diesel is that we need to ensure fuel should be available. In case of gasoline, you can use BS4 fuel on BS6, and evaluations and testing have been done by manufacturers, including Maruti Suzuki, and we are okay with that. However, for diesel, there is an issue because of the high sulfur content. The after-treatment system can become choked and can lead to issues going forward. So this means that there is a huge cost burden on the diesel. There is a cost burden, especially in a small car. Even when you talk about 8,000 rupees or 15,000 rupees cost, translates into maybe about 12,000-13,000 rupees to 20,000-22,000 rupees. That's a significant cost up for the customer.
So as you have already seen this, done that, how do you see the market dynamics changing with the entire BS6 coming in the market in terms of, you know, segment? Do you see some kind of segment upgrade, and will Maruti do away with some of the model in the long term?
We are not planning to do away any of the models. We are done away with the diesel powertrain at the moment for the BS6. So the 1.3 litre anyway will go off. And we have the other 1.5 litre which we have recently launched in the BS4. We are already said that in case there is a need of the customer and we are able to make that price point, and if the customer acceptance is there, maybe we'll look at 1.5 litre at a future
diesel
date. At a future date, but not now, as of now. That is something which is we need to work. And you talked about
the market.
There is going to be definitely a shift. Today you see a petrol to diesel, the price difference is maybe 8-9 rupees in the market. Even though the fuel efficiency is higher in a diesel engine by about 20-25%, the acquisition cost being higher, so the small car segment will see a decline in the diesel. You will see diesels in the UV segment and maybe the SUV segment going forward. So current 35%-40% of diesel penetration is likely to come down to maybe 15-20% is the one direction which I see. The second direction I see is that there is an emphasis on CNG by the government of gas-based economy. And so therefore, we do feel that CNG is going to be a large gainer in this. And Maruti Suzuki would like to participate in that. We are working with the gas companies and IOCL. Who are already bid for the new stations, 10,000 stations which are there. And they are setting up, they have plans to do that. We are working very closely with them. We already have 7 models which are CNG. We believe that, we feel that all these small cars should be converted to CNG going forward. That's the other shift which I see.
What is the direction in terms of electrification of your models, because
for
electrification of the models?
Well, electrification is also one thing which we all manufacturers will need to do. We have already started it by introducing the smart hybrid technology. We have moved from a 12 volt system in the diesel to a two battery system with lithium ion battery in the K15 engine. And going forward, our alliance with Toyota will help us to bring in the strong hybrid technology in the future. So that is definitely one of the things which we'll do in electrification. And the second thing is going to be the electric vehicle strategy. We already have made 50 vehicles, prototypes which are running in India, trying to understand the need or the needs of the customer in terms of charging, in terms of range, and put it in different use cases to understand what happens. And then based on that, we are continuing our product development work on that.
So is it going to be in line with what the earlier announcement was, that by 2020 you will roll out?
Yeah, I mean, we are working towards that at the moment.
It will be met, right?
We are working towards it.
Yes. Okay. What kind of chemistry are you using in your battery packs? Is there different, or it's lithium-based?
It's lithium-based, definitely. But it is lithium-based, but we'll talk more about it later.
Not now. Okay. Looking at the current market scenario, which is on, of obviously everybody knows it's not
tough
in
situation.
Good shape.
Yeah.
And how, for an R&D person or an engineering person, How do you see this situation? How can you leverage this situation?
Well, these are, you know, cycles which happen in the auto industry, and we have, it's not that we have not seen it in the past. What does happen as far as me as an engineering person or we as a company is concerned is how do we look at our strengths and how do we engage with our extended ecosystem, which is both suppliers as well as dealers, in order to make the best of the current situation, make them stronger in a way. Also help in whatever way in which we can do to tide over the crisis. Internally, from a product development perspective, we are working on whatever is the product development plan. There's no let up as far as the investment in that is concerned. Because in a cycle, there is a downturn. But we are looking at industry which is 5 years, 10 years, 15 years going forward. Even if you look at a five-year strategy, we have to continue our product development effort. We have to continue to meet the future regulatory requirements or future customer requirements, compete in the market. So these are things which have to happen. So that investment and resource and all of that is to happen anyway. The only thing which is going to happen is how can we further do it at a much better competitive way. At much lower cost, how can we tighten our belt? Gives us an opportunity, not just as Maruti Suzuki, or also our suppliers, to look internally to improve the operations, improve, do Kaizen, do value engineering, value analysis. And so that is a continuous effort which we'll have to do. So that's how I look at it from a technology point of view. It's an opportunity. To reinvent, relook at it, and look at the future in a positive way.
Thank you so much, Mr. Raman, for talking to ETO.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.